Listen, there's no magic bullet. I'm teaching life skills.
Men and women, bottom line, we need to have the conversation. Your partner wants to give up control, but only if you know how to drive. This is about being the best you could ever be. Whoever you are, I don't care if you're a man, a woman, LGBTQ, space aliens.
Man School 202.
Women want good sex. Men want any sex.
Yes, pretty much. Yeah.
So if it's good sex, they'll tire you out. You know, they want it more than you want. A woman has to be careful about. She has to worry about getting raped. She has to worry about getting taken advantage of. And so those things. So the safety factor of a guy who's communicating strong, dominant energy, but not abusive energy, is what's attractive. And the you know how guys will always say, oh, all they want is the bad boys. Yeah, they want the bad boys because the bad boys are confident and direct in their approach. And their bad boys are going to go, this is what I want and I deserve that, right? The problem is that there's no empathy and then it becomes abusive. Having boundaries and sticking to those boundaries are things that says to her, it communicates your honesty and your righteousness. So if you don't like something, you have to be confident enough to say, I don't like that. I don't want to do that.
Right.
I don't want to go to the ballet, or I don't want to go to the opera, or I do. I love the ballet, or I love it. The simple fact that you can be definitive about what you like and what you don't like, that the fact that you care about what your happiness is, says that you understand what your value is. And understanding, like, I've said I don't like it, I don't want to do it. And if you really want me to go, you can ask me to go, but understand that you're asking me to do something that I don't want to do, and I'm making a compromise. Now, if every time we turn around, I'm the only one making a compromise, then you're not. Right. You got a strong woman, and she can't find a man, and her girlfriends are going, "Oh, he's cute. Why don't you give him a chance?" That in itself is the kiss of death, yeah. Because what her friends are saying, he's a nice guy. We know you don't respect him, but give him an opportunity. So once you understand how this is, that this woman is basically rating your manhood on a scale, whether or not she should respect you or not. You can't tell a woman a strong woman to be weaker. She's not going to do that. If she's an aggressive woman, she needs a guy who matches that aggression or knows how to de-escalate that aggression. You can't tell her to be weaker, because all she's going to do is eventually she's gonna bite your head off, because you didn't really have the constitution to kind of mesh with her in the first place. So I think that's really the reason. It's like, you can't ask a woman to be less woman because you're not man enough. We've had lesbians on with lesbians with girl problems and gay dudes with guy problems and stuff. There's always a stronger person in the relationship, and that stronger person always sets the dynamic of what the relationship is. The adjustment for me was understanding that it wasn't just masculine and feminine, it's dominant and submissive, and that exists in every relationship. We have an acronym on the show. It's ACE. It's authenticity, credibility, and empathy. Right? And those are the three principles that I see. If you practice those principles, everything falls into place. I think a lot of times, like you said, when you're young, you're in your 20s or you start trying to find, most guys don't even have, they don't even have an acronym to guide them in a direction. Right. It just is whatever it is. It's however, you know, it's a hodgepodge of, like you said, things that you see.
It's just blind trial and error.
Yeah, and when I do these consultations with dudes, they always talk about what they loved about the person when they love the person. And then none of those things are present in the relationship now. I always say you gotta buy a house based on the appraisal, the present appraisal. You can't do what like it was that. Worth yeah. or prospectively what it will be worth. You got to get the appraisal for right now. And if you wait too long to buy the house, then you need to get another appraisal to see if to get the value. So I think we wage that original value into something that doesn't even exist. We just remember how great it was. And then a lot of times you ask them, you know, when the last time that happened, they'll tell you 6 or 7 years. Well, they can't remember the last yeah. time that they enjoyed each other's company. And the thing I think, the other thing is it's almost like, I'm not happy, I want to go. And somebody goes, and the ego goes, how dare you want to leave me? Even if she don't like you, even if she wants yeah. to leave you, it's still, how dare you? So it's the ego that stands in the way of like us really being honest about what makes us happy in the first place.
Young Man School 202. Better hear what I've got to say because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man. Better man.